In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, peace be with you. I welcome you all here on the 29th Sunday in Ordinary Time. The scripture reading today that call upon us that what belong to us and what belong to the world and what belong to God. How we are be the steward of those treasure and gift that God give to us. And yes, trust in God's love and mercy. We ask God forgive us as we say, Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks and for your great glory. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to anointed Cyrus, whose right hand I grasp, subduing nations before him, and making kings run in his service, opening doors before him, and leaving the gates unpaired. For the sake of Jacob, my servant, of Israel, my chosen one, I have called you by your name, giving you a title, though you knew me not. I am the Lord, and there is no other. There is no God besides me. It is I who arm you, though you know me not, so that toward the rising and the setting of the sun, people may know that there is none besides me. I am the Lord. There is no other. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
The beginning of the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy to the Church of Thessalonians, in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, grace to you and peace. We give thanks to God always for all of you, remembering you in our prayers, unceasingly calling to mind your work of faith and labor of love and endurance in hope of our Lord Jesus Christ before our God and Father, knowing, brothers and sisters loved by God, how you were chosen. For our gospel did not come to you in word alone, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit and with much conviction. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to
God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The Pharisees went off and plotted how they might entrap Jesus in speak. They sent their disciple to him with the Herodians, saying, "Teacher, we know that you are a truthful man and that you teach the way of God in accordance with the truth, and you are not concerned with anyone's opinion, for you do not regard a person's statues. Tell us then, what is your opinion? It is lawful to pay the census tax to Caesar or not?" Knowing their malice, Jesus said, "Why are you testing me, you hypocrites? Show me the coin that pays the census tax." Then they handed him the Roman coin. He said to them, "Whose image is this, and whose inscription?" They replied, "Caesar." At that, he said to them, "They then repay to Caesar what belonged to Caesar, and to God what belonged to God." The Gospel of the Lord. I welcome you here on the 29th Sunday of Ordinary Time. And yes, I welcome those special guests who came here today for the wedding of Janice at 10 a.m. and some of you who attend those weddings. And I also welcome the parents who bring your child here for the baptism after this Mass. We yield to do the baptism during Mass because during this time coronavirus, so we have to follow the state regulation, the diocese direction and guideline, and what we can do in our parish. From me to your place, 6 feet with the distance so I can take off my mask and so talk with you. From the choir singing for us today, and they recommend not singing because when you sing, you stress out the virus. So from them to you have to be 30 feet. And so we thank God for the bigger church. We are safe. They are all far away from you. And so all of these regulations before you are here, I hope you follow the direction you have to take and you are healthy. And so you are healthy, you are here because the community have to be healthy in order to praise and care for the member of the community. And just all of this, when you are in the pews, if you are same family, you can sit together. But if you are separate family, you have to sit the distance 6 feet. The reason why I remind you all this from the scientific viewpoint, that the way for safety, and the church, we always feel safety is important. Thank God we reopened the church last 6-7 months. There's no case that happened when we gather to celebrate Mass or the sacrament. And we thank God for this blessing. Today that we hear from the scripture reading the word of God, and with the very important, what the Pharisee and Herodian come in to approach Jesus with the difficult question to entrap him and ask him, what should we do? Do we have to pay tax or not? And what we should do because you are the holy man, and yet you don't care much, but you have the full of wisdom. And so Jesus say, and so for me today, I say to you too, I have one $10 bill here. So look at the $10 bill or any of the coin that for American money, we always have what it in here say, in God we trust. In God we trust. Wonderful American, the country, we have the deep faith in God. In God we trust. And yet Jesus answer, look at the coin. What the image in that coin? If the Caesar, and you have to pay the tax. Because according to the old law in the Old Testament, that we have to pay the tax for the soil and all the things that you should. So Jesus advised us, we should, because God gave us the leader, government leader who care for us. And yet together that we care for the country and we take care one another. And yet we also in the law say 10% that we have to pay for what we have. So looking into what belongs to God and what belongs to us. And yet the stewardship is the good time for us to make. Each one of us need to meditate upon God that gave us everything. Our life, my life, I'm living, I speak with you, it belongs to the Lord. If the Lord gave me this life in serving you, in sharing with you, I know that belongs to God. Everything I have, I wear, yes, it belongs to the Lord who gave to me. And I work and yes, be the stewardship that he gave me knowledge, wisdom, and all. And so what should we do? Do we give back to God enough for what God needs in sharing with people? Stewardship for the treasure at this time, you receive my letter. And yes, I report to you what we have done for this parish at St. Anne last year. We have done an excellent job. And you should be very proud of what little bit I report to you, because the shortage of the staff and the leadership, we do the best we can, just highlight what we have done. but more than what we have in the report to you. And so we already gave back to the Lord anything what we can. But the most that for us, for the examination of conscience, as you know, November coming up, the election coming up. So our obligation that we have to study about the church social teaching, and yet several documents I post on the website and bulletin, examination of conscience and be faithful citizen. And yes, all the candidates, they have different viewpoint, different thing. But you have to know we are Catholic and what the church teaching, how we can be the steward of this social teaching. Of course, we have to care for the life that God gave to us from the moment of conception to natural death. The church teaching very clear, not only for the unborn that, but also for the poor, the needy, the elderly, especially at this time, coronavirus killing so many people at this time. And yet how we care for them. Many immigration, many poor, and yes, all of these. And yes, we, God gave us the knowledge, the wisdom, and vote. You have to go to vote. And yet before you go and you already receive, I receive my envelope and voting already, I'm working on it. Now I'm praying on it and all, and I believe many of you do. You can send in, you can drop in the mailbox, or you can stop by at the station. And also that next few weeks, you also receive the letter on the stewardship, how we can make the commitment. What belongs to God? What belongs to us? How we can be a good steward of God's love and care and treasure that giving to us? And so I ask you, please, during this month of October, I always call upon you, come for daily mass, pray the rosary before, through the intercession of the Virgin Mary, the Lady of Wisdom, always guide us on what we need to do. And also pray for one another, especially many people who are sick, that we need to remember them in our prayer. The family who are mourning for their loved one, every week they have funeral. And also, one of the members from this choir who also coming in, Karen, who sing, and she also passed away last week. Her funeral will be on October 30th. I hope the family informed you, but as I'm working with them, and so that will be 11 o'clock for Karen, that the formal parishioner of Holy Rosary, and yes, she also singing in this choir with Ryan and Teresa and all. She passed away. She have been cremation next few days, and her memorial mass on October 30. Remember her, and many people pray for the people who are joining the church as newly member who baptized today and tomorrow and the coming week. And we have the religious education program beginning tomorrow at St. John of the Wood for opening for the CCD there. On Wednesday night this coming week, we have the adult education, and some of you already registered, and also the class will be open for CCD. And so please join us and pray for those ministry of the parish that we have at this time. So please stand together. We join one another to profess our faith as we say, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. We gather the community, we offer our law, our prayer, and our petition as we sing.
That the church continue to preach the gospel with power and conviction, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That governments ensure fair taxes and provide needed services, especially for the poor, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That communities work together to end neglect and abuse, especially of children, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That neighborhoods at every economic level provide safe haven for those in crisis, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who come to this table be nourished with love, especially those who live alone, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, especially Dave Rooney, that they may enjoy the fullness of God's heavenly glory, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We offer now our personal intentions. We send all the prayers entered in our book of prayer and those that are held in our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We ask you to bless upon the prayer we offer you. Bless upon the baby who are about to baptize after Mass today and those who baptize tomorrow. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Lord, receive my sacrifice, Christ. Pray now that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your giver, that through the purifying actions of your race, we may be cleaned by the very mysteries we serve, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word, through whom you make all things, whom you send as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for your holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and enter willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this off of you and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have helped us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread through all the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Paul, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That's with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the several command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, raises and peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who say to your apostle, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you. Let us always offer the sign of peace and love. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter my roof. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepare for the gifts that are eternal through Christ our Lord. Thank you so much for coming to the church, those who come regularly, those who newly coming today. As you know, we try to be safety, and so it quite a little different when you are full time here. So I thank you for your patience, and yes, it's very important for us to keep the mask short, and so that's why I try the best I can, that the recommendation. But thank you for being here, and may God continue to bless upon you and your family. So the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace and serve the Lord.